Don't be shy when you say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Yes, these are powerful words of Allah. But try saying Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. See what it does to you. It's different. It's the word of Allah. Do it for the sake of Allah. Wallahi, this is a remedy for your sadness. When you give the Quran, the word of Allah, the importance it is supposed to be having, it combats your sadness without you realizing. You're a happy person. People look at you. You have bigger problems than all of them put together, but you are smiling. You still say, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah. People think you've got no issue. There is nobody on earth who has no issue. Remember that. It's just the way they are managing and coping is different. You think you have a problem. Wallahi, there are people sitting right near you in the same masjid that perhaps have problems 100 times the size of yours, but you won't realize it. They have a link with Allah. They know this world is temporary. That brings me to another point. Once you've developed your link with the Quran and you try to read and you try to understand and you try to put things forth and you develop a link with Allah and your dhikr, remembrance of Allah, is in order, your salah is in order, you need to be able to appreciate what Allah has given you that He has not given others. That is one way of combating your sadness. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, "Unzuru ila man huwa dunakum." Look at those who have less than you, who are lower than you. In the Quran, Allah speaks about problems that almost break the backs of people. When the Prophet ﷺ had a problem, it was not connected to him or his dunya. It was connected to the deen, the religion. That's why I said, you ask yourself a question, is this matter related to the deen or the dunya? The matter I am sad about, is it, if it's connected to the deen, then yes, it is a matter I should be sad about. I combat it in a similar way. But if it is connected to the dunya or this life, then I need to know, number one, life is temporary. Days do not last. It will not be the same. After nightfall comes day, and after day comes night. Remember that. That's the plan of Allah. A lot of us are sad because of something temporary. You lost wealth. Everybody's lost wealth. Nobody seated here has not suffered a loss. Everybody has. They've dealt with it differently. They've suffered at different levels. Allah tests you according to your level. In one narration, the hadith says, Allah tests you according to how much He loves you. When He loves you more, He tests you more. That's a hadith. It's because when you have a problem and an issue, it is human nature that when you have a problem, you start looking for solutions. And a believer will look for solutions by getting close to Allah. So when Allah wants you to become very close to Him, He gives you a bigger problem because He knows if you didn't have this one major issue in your life, perhaps you wouldn't even be bothered about reading salah. You wouldn't even be bothered about calling out to Allah.